Work on the Nord Stream pipeline is in full swing. Since April 2010, three massive pipe-laying vessels have laid different sections on the first of Nord Stream's twin pipelines. So far, more than 71,000 large-diameter 12-meter steel pipes have been shipped from the Finnish ports of Kotka to Hanko. Each pipe had been coated in concrete first to double its weight to 24 tons and ensure stability on the seabed. All in all, 10,000 pipes were shipped out from there to the world's largest pipe-laying vessel, Allseas Solitaire, which had been commissioned to lay pipe in the challenging Gulf of Finland. The teams working on the project have had to deal with particularly harsh winter conditions, for example, at the port of Hanko. The icy conditions came a month earlier than usual and presented major challenges to the construction activities. Throughout the area, work had to be adapted according to the weather conditions to ensure the safety of all activities. For example, manpower has more than doubled at the port of Hanko.
If we compare for the summertime loadouts what we had here, we can compare that we had approximately 12 person for the loadout working and taking these pipes to be loaded out. But in these winter conditions, we have increased the manpower till 28 people in one shift. And we are doing three shifts a row, so it means 28 people times three. And all the people are working here just to get the de-iced clean, the pipes clean. So it means that we are using actually almost 20 people to get these pipes clean before loading out these pipes.
When the temperatures in Finland dropped below freezing point, Nord Stream's partner, Oypec, had to mobilize additional cleaning equipment for the marshalling yard to de-ice pipes, as the pipes have to be supplied to the pipe carrier vessels without ice. To ensure the uninterrupted supply of pipe to the Solitaire, the pipe-lay contractor Allseas mobilized three ice-class pipe supply vessels like the Trans Pollux.
When we started here in Hanko site, first it was easy to clean the pipes with the air-blowing system. And the air-blowing system was developed here as a homemade system to clean these pipes. There hasn't been before this any different kind of tools. How do you get rid of the snow and ice? So we have been inventing now air blowing system first to clean the pipes, and the second station of this will be the steaming. We are placing 80 degrees water on the pipes to melt the ice down, and the third station will be taking the end caps off, where we have also two hosing guys with the warm water to take all the rest ice off.
All in all, Nord Stream and its contractors have managed to overcome the challenges of a particularly severe winter, thanks to the special efforts which all involved parties put into completing the construction activities.